Welcome everybody to another daily vlog. It's a vlog that happens daily, sometimes right here in Nashville, Tennessee, in the middle of a torrential downpour. I love fueling up and starting my mornings just like this. It makes life worth living. Home of Mark Twain. Look on top of this light. A selfie stick on a camera. Or a camera on top of a selfie stick. Now that's just not the only light that has a camera. Wait until we get up here just a little ways into downtown Hannibal. Hannibal probably has more speed trap cameras.
In a quarter mile, turn left.
Than any city in America, you know, per populace. It's one road, maybe three or four stoplights, and probably 100 cameras. You gotta be really careful if you come to see some Mark Twain.
Turn left onto Paris Gravel Road.
No, thank you, Google. Stoplight in town, you have two cameras there, two cameras across the street, two more cameras in the middle of the street, two more cameras on the opposite side by that truck, and two more cameras over there. It's insane. Insane. Let's get to the next stoplight. Smile. You're on Hannibal, Missouri camera time. Let's see. Here's another one. There's two more there. Two more there. That's a hidden one. With a nice flash bulb on it. I'd like to have that flash. And as usual, all the way around. And this isn't even the bad one. None of these are actually bad. The worst one is just down the street. The next stoplight is probably the worst speed trap in all of America. And the speed limit's only 35. But if your bumper crosses over that line, they have these sensors. If your bumper just crosses over the white line, which I notice a lot of people do when I drive, I notice wherever I go, lots of people cross that white line. It takes a picture, boom, $125 ticket. I know, I've gotten lots of tickets in this town. Not running a stoplight or not doing anything, but just having my bumper too close to that white line to start that flash over there. Here it is, the last big stoplight coming up. What makes this one bad? Not this one, but the next one. They're like right next to each other. Normally, if you hit this red light with all these cameras, normally you stop, and then in a truck, it takes a second to shift and get going. By the time you're into first gear, the light's already switched to red again. And this light up here is the same way. They go from red or green to red in a matter of seconds. Probably would not have put those in today's daily vlog coming through here because I come through here so often. Hannibal, Missouri. I love the town. Love all the Mark Twain history around here. The only reason I actually put those in today's vlog is because they're so into cameras and surveillance across this little baby town that they put a camera on a selfie stick on a light pole. That was new, so I found that unique, so I figured I'd document that real fast. That's the only reason I put the stoplights or the cameras in today's vlog, was because of a selfie stick camera tied to the light pole. I thought that was odd. I am in the middle of Iowa now. I've passed a lot of things I didn't document. I just kept driving and driving. I parked, slept for a little bit, hence the hat on the messed up hair. Just depressed and feeling kind of antisocial. Not really videoing much and documenting much as I drive down the road. And I don't know why. I don't know why I felt that way. I just, for some reason, kind of had the blues a little bit, but there was no reason to have the blues. I don't know why they kicked in, but they did. I don't know if it had to do with all the recent events in the news, and I watched those crazy first-person cell phone videos of the murders that have been going on, in Baton Rouge and the one up in St. Paul, Minnesota area. And seeing that little four-year-old girl, I don't know, it just got to me. And then now debating in social networks with other people that think those cases are justified shootings, and I don't believe they're justified shootings, and so having discussions, which is pretty amazing, having discussions with someone you totally disagree with, and not arguing and fighting and calling each other names, that was pretty amazing. That's why I like Google Plus. You could actually communicate, point, or voice your opinion. They could voice their opinion, and there's no fighting or arguing going on. And the person that I'm debating or talking with that lives in Texas, if you watch this video and you know who you are, you're awesome. Though I disagree with some of your thoughts, it's nice to be able to communicate like this and discuss things. Thank you, Google Plus, for having a much smarter, or I don't know if, I'm not calling other social network people that frequent other social networks stupid. I'm not. It's just, you don't get that type of discussion on other social networks without eventually breaking into fights and or verbally texting, fighting. You know what I mean. I can't explain it, but it's not. It's just refreshing. It's refreshing that you can discuss your beliefs with someone else that has totally different beliefs on the way they see things, especially within these two videos that have been produced over the last 2 days. And I'm trying not to bring my videos down, bring politics, bring religion, or bring society's woes into my videos. But because these things have been emotionally affecting me lately, I just decided to talk about it a little bit. And because they emotionally affected me to the point to where it brought me down and gave me the blues, you know, which they should bring. Everybody should have thoughts on this. It's crazy. It's just crazy. And but I'm taking it all out of my video. I'm not going to discuss it anymore. I'll leave that to the professionals. I'm going to go back to what I normally do and document my day. Though this was part of my day, so I guess this should be part of the documentation of what I do and what I think throughout the day. What I'm thinking right now is Iowa has a lot of corn. A lot. Look at all this corn. It's surrounding me. Surrounding me. It's everywhere. It's going to be one of those days. I just checked into security. Right back here behind me. Security. And I'm a few hours early, which is awesome. But I try and get here at places a few hours early always. Just because sometimes they'll let you in early. Well, this time they won't let me in at all. And I've been here a few times, but they changed their policies. Now you have to have one of those construction orange vests to deliver your load. Even if you're not getting out of your vehicle. Even if you're sitting in your vehicle, you have to have an orange vest on. They do not provide the orange vest, where I was under the assumption, well, if you're going to have this rule, you should provide a vest. Whether if they're disposable or you hand a driver one, they signs for it. And upon exit of the security, he would hand over his vest and leave. A lot of places do that. Well, they do not provide them. I have to take a long walk about three roads up. There's a Walmart, and I have to go purchase a vest so I can deliver my load and get out of here. Get out of here. So they're still getting used to this new law that they have created, and there's going to be changes into it, but at this moment I have to go purchase a vest. So let's head over to Walmart. Everything's over here in the men's area. I figured it would be in the sporty goods area, maybe the boating section. Well, I don't know why I would think it would be in the boating section, but I was thinking sporting goods section, kind of, just because bicycles and stuff like that, you would think maybe some bicyclists like to wear them. So I was looking in that area, and then I came to the conclusion that maybe they don't have them. But then I asked an employee, they said go over to the men's clothing area and look over there. Maybe just a bright orange shirt will do. I don't know. Let's walk around here. There's got to be something. I'm in the men's area right now. It was just socks. Is it something that color? Maybe something like that. I don't know. People are looking at me weird. Hey, I found them. Here they are. Black vests. Maybe it's something I could use on my motorcycle too. So it's probably not a bad purchase. I ride my motorcycle at night. I should probably get a good one, not just some cheap $11 thing that's gonna flap in the wind, but maybe something a little bit more high quality. Both these look pretty good. I kinda like this yellow. I'm thinking that's what I'm gonna get. I think I'm gonna go above and beyond what is probably necessary. What size is this? Let me see, that's an XL. I definitely don't need an XL. Two XL. Medium. Large. Here we go. I don't think I could use a medium. And I don't think I could use a large. But to get the medium is in the very back, or the large is in the very back, and it doesn't have one of these clippy clips on it. So I gotta remove all these just to get to the back. Just to get to the one I want. And there it is. There's the one I want. See, no clippy clip. Nice though. Well, let's go pay for this and head back to the truck. It's done. I purchased it. I have it ready to go. Now I can get unloaded in peace without being tormented by the dreaded security police here at this place. Actually, they're pretty nice people. They're just trying to follow their rules and regulations that are handed down to them to enforce upon us. And we must bow our heads just like, I don't know. I guess everybody expects us to just bow our heads. Bow, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Though, if you want your product, it should be a little bit nicer. Though, they're pretty nice. I'm not going to complain too much. I just find it irritating that if you're going to enforce a law and you will not let people on your property. I mean, I've been to places where they go, okay, do you have normal shoes? Because a lot of times I walk around in flip-flops. And then I leave my normal shoes in the cab of the truck. And they'll say, well, before you enter the property, you need to put your normal shoes on. And I hope that they're steel toe. No, my Vans, my Nikes, all that shoes, Converse, whatever, they're non-steel toe. Well, you can't come on the property without steel toe. But yet they will provide you with these little steel toe heavy things that go on the front of your shoe and you strap them on. They provide them because it's their policy that you have steel toe shoes to go into their warehouse. And most warehouses provide these if they require them. And it's just weird. You would think that it would be common knowledge that most truck drivers probably don't carry an orange vest. Here at Caribou Coffee, on my way back to my vehicle, got me some mocha icy goodness and a three cheese classic sandwich to tide me over till lunchtime. Well, this is probably going to be considered lunch, but heading back, hopefully they're going to call me soon and they're going to be pleased as punch that a truck driver did not give them any grief or gruff and actually walked way back there to purchase what they should have gave us in the first place. Starbucks, eat your heart out. look at this awesome cheesy grilled cheese sandwich. Three cheese! Starbucks makes some pretty good food. They really do. Caribou Coffee, though, giving you guys a run for your money. Not only with great food like this, but awesome dark chocolate icy coffee goodness. Well, I did not receive a phone call. I'm looking at my phone. I just got back to my truck. No phone call, so they're not ready for me. But I'm ready for them. Ready for them. And then from here, I head over to Osceola, Iowa, and then down to Dayton, Ohio. But it all depends on how fast they get me out of here. Hopefully, not until after I finish this. It's a little ass. Put on some reflective gear. And you know what? They unload you 4 hours early. Thank you so much, sir. They thanked me profusely. Actually, pretty nice security guards. Just doing their job. No reason to get all flustered and get into an argument. Just go blow a little bit of money on something that you could probably use in your off time, like on a motorcycle. And not only are you safe on your motorcycle, they also let you into a door early. What's the saying? You catch more flies with sugar, but I mean, who would want to catch flies? I don't know. In this case, my door being the fly. Well, it's been about 2 hours, been back into the door. They're finally starting to unload me. Oh, I just got a head rush from getting up. I've been sitting here watching YouTube videos. Right there, been watching some YouTube and thought to myself, I better add a little bit more talking to my video so I can get this done, upload it. Not that I'm not, well, there's just nothing going on today. I'm just getting it unloaded, gonna go pick up another load, head down to Dayton. So there's really not much to do or see or record, but I try and do these on a daily basis, and that's why I'm doing this. But last night, I did, if you look up front here, if you see, right there between the seats. See that tripod? Where's it at? That tripod right there, that big tripod. I did put my Osmo on there last night. Recorded a video. Let me set you guys up a little bit. Boy, this tripod with these flexible legs is kind of hard to get just right because it all gets all twisted. Twisted and like right now, you guys are kind of sitting sideways. Why are you guys sitting sideways? But I set my Osmo on that tripod over there, which is not flexible like this one, and shot a video, about a 5 minute 2K. I was gonna shoot it in 4K, but I shot it in 2K. Tried to upload it into my Chromebook, couldn't figure it out. It would not work. So I ended up deleting it, formatting the memory card, not only in the Osmo, but also in my Canon, so I got fresh memory cards again, and I'll try shooting higher quality video again on that, and seeing if I can do it in my Chromebook. If I can't do it, I'm gonna end up having to purchase a Windows or a Mac PC. I don't know, because I do wanna start uploading 4K, 2K, high quality 1080p. But when I was talking last night on my video that I was recording, I was talking about my Google Glass. Actually, Roxanne told me I should probably shoot a quick video using my Osmo talking about my glass, because my Prism no longer works. It doesn't work. For a couple days, it wouldn't even charge. I could not get my glasses to charge. Well, they're charging again. They are working. They work fully perfect, except for the Prism. The Prism still does not work. But I've had Google Glass for 4 years now, right around 4 years. So I know if I tilt my head up and down and I hear the ding, I know that means the clock is up and I can speak what I want, like show me the weather or take a picture or record a video. I know that I could do that. I know where the cards are. If I swipe forward, I know what the next card is. So that's just from using them a lot. But if I need to visually see something that I can't see because my Prism no longer works, I forgot. My CD. I totally forgot that I can mirror what the camera sees onto the mobile device that these are synced with, which is a mobile device that I have up there. Let me kill this. Kill that CB. So, like if I said, okay, let me make sure they're not on. I can't tell because there's nothing in here. So I swipe down, swipe, swipe. Okay, so if I say the words, okay, glass, show me the weather, I can't see the weather. I can't see that satellite image moving through here. But if I go to the My Glass application and mirror what the camera sees or what the computer sees inside, I could actually view it on my mobile device. I forgot that you could do that. I have in 4 years, I rarely mirrored my glass, except for a couple demonstrations, like if I'm walking around CES or Disney or Universal, and someone wants to see what it's like, what I'm seeing, I could usually show them my device, open it up, and they could see what I'm seeing. So, but I haven't done demonstrations like that in the last couple years because most of the time I would just take my glasses off and hand the people the glass. But now it's a function that has become a necessity for me since Google is no longer replacing our glasses. And I was really bummed out when this happened, when my screen turned blue, then pink, and then blue again, and then totally went out on me. I was pretty upset because I use these on a daily basis, and I thought my Google Glass exploring days were over. They're not. I could still record video. I could still take pictures, and if I need to use it for something that information that I can't get from my watch or my mobile devices, I could still use this using the screen on my mobile device itself. So that's what I was shooting the video for, using my Osmo. I just couldn't figure out how to upload higher quality video using a Chromebook. For some reason, YouTube kept saying, cannot upload. Don't know what it is. I'll figure it out. And if I can't, I see a brand new PC or Mac in my future. I don't own any Apple products anymore. None. And I think if I was going to purchase an Apple product, it would probably be a MacBook of some kind. Right? I don't like iOS products, but I think I might really like a MacBook. If they could drop down in price a little, I think I'm going to look for older versions. Maybe last year's model or 2 years old models. If it comes down to that, if it comes down to where I can't actually transfer to YouTube from a Chromebook. Plus, I think the video editing would be a lot easier in a Mac or on a PC, Windows PC, rather than editing in a cloud on the Chromebook. I feel so much better, but I got the sniffles, I got the cough, my cold is gone. I feel great. It's just my schnoz still running. I still got the cough. I still got the cough. All right, guys, I'm out of here. I'm going to go ahead and sign off. Edit this together real quicky quick. Upload it for my daily vlog. And start heading down to Dayton. Right? See what we could find. I don't think we could find much but cornfields. Probably that's it. Just cornfields. But we'll see. So, from Acony, Iowa, and my brand new attire. You like that? You like this new attire? I might wear this all the time. Shirtless. I might go shirtless. Just wear this and go shirtless. Nah, I can't do that. All right, everybody, please remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, and I will talk to you on the next one. Peace.